I'm Starborn. Remember, to be a star, you have to shine your own light, follow your own path, and not worry about the darkness, because that's when stars shine brightest. In fact, if you've been looking at our website, starborninstitute.org, you would know that the title of tonight's show is an action-oriented title. It's called Make It Happen. And the reason why is that there are six wonderful planets in the expressive air signs, and that can indicate a lot of getting together and communication and planning and scheduling for something that you may want to do. So this is a wonderful time to go ahead and join others, because there are four planets in Libra and they are trying two more in Aquarius. The Sun, Mercury, the planet of the mind and of communication, and Venus and Saturn are all in Libra, which does rule partnership or business endeavors or contracts. Those four planets are trying the Moon today and Neptune in Aquarius, which rules the future. So naturally, you may have your mind on your future plans. Together, those six planets all trying the sign of Gemini, which does rule communication or short-term projects, and it certainly rules promoting, advertising, journalism, buying and selling, and sort of wheeling and dealing. So this is certainly a time when you can get together with other people and plan on making something happen. If it is associated with your future plans, they may be plans that you have tried once before, and that's because Neptune is retrograde in Aquarius. So you might have to try them again, and you may need a little bit more help this time, but you would be able to find good helpmates or partners now with so many planets in Libra, because Libra does rule partnership. So this may be a time when you, as you reconsider a plan that may have failed in the past, or perhaps it stalled for one reason or another, this time around, you may decide that by reinventing yourself, you may be able to be successful with your plans. So give something another try right now, because I think that will really help you get something off the ground, and then you'll be able to make it happen. Another reason why you can go ahead and be in the planning or the scheduling stage and be focused on making something happen is because today there are no planets in water signs. There's nothing in Cancer or Pisces or Scorpio. And since the water signs rule our feelings, that's an indication that we already know what our feelings are. We don't have to examine them. And we know not only how we feel about each other, we know how we feel about current world conditions as well. So you can skip all that kind of examination. And since there are two dynamic planets in fire signs, you could probably move swiftly ahead right now if you were a little bit beyond the planning stage and able to go ahead and put something into motion. And that is because Mars, that planet of dynamic energy, is in Leo, a fire sign, and it is trining Uranus, another planet which rules the future and does rule sudden change, which is in Aries, another fire sign. So there could be an awful lot of people that really want to get something off the ground right now. And if you are one of them, you're going to have a lot of help, and that will be good. Another reason why you might want to start something new or give something another try is because Jupiter is retrograde in Taurus right now, a financial sign, and it is trining Pluto in Capricorn, which rules big business and government agencies, but Capricorn also rules long-term security. Since Jupiter is in very good aspect to Pluto, but it is retrograde or a little bit weaker, this may be a time when you may want to modify your long-term plans. A suggestion would be that if you're at all close to retirement, you might want to go ahead and consider taking early retirement so that you could have a little nest egg that you could fall back on as you do get something together and make it happen, or as you do try something new. So there's nothing wrong with that. Or it can simply be that the value of your investments have fluctuated so much that they no longer fit into your long-term plans, and you may want to do a little buying and selling or communicating about that, and this would be an excellent time for that as well. So with these wonderful planets, particularly the four planets in Libra, the Sun, Mercury, Venus, and Saturn, trining the Moon and Neptune today in Aquarius. This is an excellent time for you to join forces or to form a partnership or start a business or get something really off the ground and get it underway. So since Libra does rule the law, this is the time to make something legal or to actually be very, very serious, particularly about something that you have been involved with long term already, and make a solid commitment. Make it legal, make it last. This is an excellent time to do that, and it would be something where you really want to make a commitment to someone you trust or to a goal that you have that you may have for the rest of your life. There's nothing wrong with getting really serious right now because it could be very rewarding and you would be sure of yourself. All right, what does this mean to all 12 of the sun signs? Well, Aries, for you, I think with those four planets in Libra all opposing your sun, there can be a lot of people that want to form a partnership and they could have very high standards and be a little bit strict in what they want as their terms for partnership right now. That may not interest you at all, Aries, because remember I said there are two planets in fire signs, Uranus, which rules the future and rules sudden change, which is in your sign. Uranus also rules freedom. And since it is retrograde, you may want to go back to some project that perhaps had not gotten off the ground, and you might want to give that another try right now because you don't feel like being tied down or having to do things other people's way. In fact, you could feel very boxed in and challenged right now, and you could be on the losing end of some sort of legal decision. So this could be an excellent time to get something off the ground and make it happen. And with Mars in Leo trine your sun where you have Uranus, you would get a lot of help with that right now, Aries. So do what you're just naturally good at. And I don't think that you're naturally good at partnership. In other words, yours is the sign of the pioneer. You're the person that likes to sort of go out on a limb and get something started, and you can be extremely successful at that. It's what you do well, Aries. So I hope you do give that a try. All right, what does it mean to a Taurus? Well, Taurus, I think that you are a person who is going to have to modify your long-term financial goals. And the reason why is that yours is a financial sign and it does rule investments. And since Taurus is the sign of the good provider and you're a good hard worker and you work for the joy and the love not only of doing it, but in order to be good to your loved ones as well. So love is in the mix of all of your actions. And since Jupiter is in your sign, you can be very optimistic, but since that planet is going retrograde and will stay that way until December, you may have to go back and redo some of your investments because their value may have fluctuated. And in one sense, if this was a world that was progressing and looked economically bright, which I don't think it is right now, I think it's too volatile, some people would say, well, make an investment by buying something when it's low priced. But think about it, Taurus, if that were true all the time, then some people would lose their shirts because you don't really want to buy when something is too low priced. In other words, it could be going down and it could be out and you could lose all your money. Well, you don't want to do that, do you, Taurus? So this is a time when you really do need to look over your long-term financial strategy and see if it's paying off for you now or if you think it will in the future. Because remember, if we modify our strategies a little bit, maybe there's an asset around that you could sell that would give you some sort of a cash backup so that you could try something new or you could reinvest your money. So I think this is a time when you need to look all that over pretty carefully, Taurus, and make something happen for the long run and for your loved ones. But I think it's going to have to be something that you modify because I don't think you can continue on with your current financial strategies because there's so much uncertainty in the world. And you need to get on top of that a little bit right now before you lose any money or lose any more money. Okay, what does it mean to a Gemini? Well, Gemini, you are the lucky one, and that is because those six planets, four in Libra and two in Aquarius today, are all trining your sun, and one of them is your ruler, Mercury, Gemini. And so I would say that you can be the recipient of a lot of good ideas and communication right now coming from a lot of different sources. And it may be that by bouncing your ideas off other people or them bringing you some fresh ideas, you too could make something happen. And it could be something that you tweak, that you turn around a little bit, or that you use as a stepping stone in order to get you going in a new direction. Because everybody can profit right now by communicating with other people, by buying and selling and promoting, and by taking on perhaps short-term extra projects that help fit in with a strategy that involves new endeavors. Even if you have to try something again, Gemini, this would be an excellent time to at least get good advice or consult with people, because they could help you get to your next destination. And I think you're going to be real lucky by getting good consultations from people right now. So I hope you're in the mood to listen, Gemini. All right, what does it mean to a Cancer? Well, Cancer, remember I mentioned there are no planets in water signs, and that's all right because we're already quite sure of our feelings, and that's good. So you don't need to question your own feelings, Cancer. But on the other hand, since there are four planets in Libra and they all square your sun and they are all wonderful planets, it simply is an indication that other people are going to make decisions or form commitments, perhaps legal commitments, that are not in agreement with how you think things should be done. And what I want to advise you on, Cancer, since there really is no support for the water signs right now, is that yes, you're sure of your feelings, but how about giving someone else the benefit of the doubt and understanding that they are pretty sure of their feelings as well? And so I think you just need to trust that others are doing what they feel is right for them at this current time. And if you sort of stay out of things right now or stay in the background, Cancer, I think that there will be much less stress on you. And I don't see you winning an argument right now, so I sure hope you don't get in one. All right, what does it mean to a Leo? Well, Leo, this is an excellent time for you if you want to try something, either something brand new, or if you want to try something again, because Mars is in your sign. So I bet you are somebody who's going to make something happen, Leo, and that would be just great. Because if it means that you need to try something again, you might be very successful at that now, and that is because Uranus is in Aries. It does rule sudden change, but it's retrograde, meaning you might have to go back and, with help from others, remember all those planets in Libra are trining your, are sextiling your sun. It just means there can be some support behind you right now, Leo. I don't think it's financial support. I think it is just the help of partners or willing volunteers that can help you get a new start underway. If it is something where you are hoping to make a profit right away, I would say that you're aiming in the wrong direction, because Jupiter in Taurus, a financial sign, is squaring your sun. And today, the Moon and Neptune in Aquarius are opposing your sun. Planets are building up in fixed signs right now, which means other people have their own fixed viewpoints about things, and you are not going to be able to change them no matter how supercharged you are, Leo. So I think that you need to be real sure of where you're going, what direction you're going in, and then I do think that you'll be able to make something happen. You just have to be able to afford it, Leo, and that's why you need to sort of look at the money as well. Okay, what does it mean to a Virgo? Well, Virgo, this is a time when I think you would want to modify your long-term financial goals. And the reason why is that Jupiter in Taurus is trining your sun, and Pluto in Capricorn is also trining your sun. And because Pluto is direct, it simply means there can be a favorable judgment by management in a large corporation or a government agency. And that favorable judgment could involve a policy change that can reflect well upon you, or that you can benefit by, Virgo. So that's fine. That's all to the good. Those four planets in Libra right ahead of your sign indicate that people are opening up right now. They're wanting to make commitments or decisions, or they're wanting to make something legal, and they're sure wanting to be in partnership. Since Saturn is involved in the mix of those planets, and Saturn rules time, there's an indication that you could join forces with, or have the opportunity to become a partner with, someone you had known a very long time, Or else it can be simply that something you have been working on for a long time may be able to reach the stage of being legal, and so you should go ahead and make it legal, make it happen, Virgo. And as long as you carefully look over your investments right now, I think that you'll be able to go forward with everyone else and with long-term financial backing, which is good. Okay, what does it mean to a Libra? Well, Libra, you certainly have been busy lately, haven't you? And that's because there are so many planets in your sign, Libra. The Sun, Venus, Mercury, and an exalted Saturn are all there. But things will change by next week, Libra, and that is because Venus is at 27 degrees of Libra already, and it will quickly, in 3 days, move into Scorpio, and that's your ruler. And so since that Scorpio is a financial sign, this is simply when you have got to start looking for a little bit more money, Libra, in order to get some sort of commitment off the ground, or if you want to try something new, you may need some additional financing, and there is a pretty good chance that you would get it, Libra. And so, you know, you may look around for partners right now, and if they are partners that can offer you financial backing, so much the better, because you are a person with a great deal of experience and you have very high standards, particularly since Saturn has come into your sun sign. So this is the time for you to get real serious about getting something off the ground and making it real right now. And I hope you do it with partners, Libra, because yours is a sign that's very good at working with partnership. And that way there can be a little bit more safety in numbers. All right, what does it mean to a Scorpio? Well, Scorpio, this is the time when I think that since there are no planets in water signs, I don't think that you can actually make too many waves right now or go in too many different directions. And you may not want to, Scorpio. And the reason why is, as I mentioned, the planets are building up in fixed signs. Yours is a fixed sign, but it's the only fixed sign that doesn't have a planet in it. And that simply means then that Mars in Leo is squaring your sun, meaning there can be jealous or greedy people that have their own agendas, and they sort of don't want you included in their agenda in any way. So they can be challenging, and you may not like their plans, or their plans may not appeal to you in any way. So I don't think there's any love lost there. And Jupiter in Taurus is opposing your sun, and it is weak because it's retrograde, meaning that it can be that your investments are not necessarily paying off right now either, and it would behoove you to look at your long-term financial strategy and perhaps devote yourself to redoing that a little bit. And then today the Moon and Neptune in Aquarius are squaring your sun, meaning that other people with sort of dreamy ideas right now are not thinking about including you in their future plans. This may not break your heart, Scorpio, because there's nothing in your sign, and I don't think the choices around you are appealing to you. This may be a time when you decide to end something or quit something rather than get involved in something that you really don't have your heart in anyway. So if I were you, I'd just step back and sort of make up your mind quietly. All right, what does it mean to a Sagittarius? Well, Sagittarius, I know you're going to be busy. And the reason why is because of those other two fire signs. Mars is in Leo, and that energizes Leo, and Leo is a sign of leadership and being an entrepreneur. And Uranus is in Aries. Uranus rules sudden change, and Aries rules new starts. So with both of those planets trying your sign, Sagittarius, I think that you are going to be sort of off and running. I definitely think you're going to make something happen. And one of the reasons is that you can be very impatient to get something off the ground, or I think to try something again. In other words, remember, if you have to reinvent yourself a little bit, now is a good time to do that, Sagittarius. And particularly since I think those planets in Libra are sextiling your sun, and I think recently someone has given you the benefit of the doubt, and so now is when you really need to prove you're worth it. You're worth a person's trust, or you're worth some sort of plan that you are devoted to, and now is the time to really go in with others and make it happen. And good luck, Sagittarius, because I think you're going to do a great job. All right, what does it mean to a Capricorn? Well, Capricorn, this is simply a time when I think you are going to have to modify your long-term financial strategy, as well as Taurus and Virgo. And the reason why is that Pluto is direct in your sign, and it is trying Jupiter in Taurus. until next summer. Now, Jupiter is a little bit weak because it's going retrograde, but it will be direct by December. And so I think if you spend between now and December looking over all of the assets that you have, Capricorn, so that you can see if the money's in the right place and if it's doing you any good. Remember, there's a lot that people can do with money they've put away for retirement. And the more people that start taking a look at that and asking themselves, what else can I do with my life with a little bit of financial backing, you know, you're an inventive sign yourself, Capricorn, but you're a careful, persevering one and very security prone. And so this is a time when I advise you not to trust everyone else with your money, but take a really good look at what your money is doing for you, because it may not be enough. And if you sort of look things over, maybe you could get your money to work a little harder for you, and that could free you up to do something new or make something happen. Okay, what does it mean to an Aquarian? Well, Aquarius, the Moon and Neptune are in your sign today, lucky you. And in fact, the Moon is exactly trine the Sun in Libra today. And then Mercury is there, and so is Venus and Saturn. So I think you've got a lot of backing somewhere, and you could be lucky enough to be very close to signing a contract or attracting a very worthwhile partner, Aquarius. And if that involves you having to reinvent yourself a little bit to make yourself more attractive to a partner, I strongly advise you to do that, Aquarius, because you have a lot to gain from that. And also, if you need to try something again and reinvent yourself at the same time as well, you could do it. And that's because you just understand yourself a little bit better now, Aquarius. Remember, the Moon is in your sign, so you're very aware of your feelings. And you can see potential partners in a new light. And maybe they're even the same old people, but you can be seeing them in a new way now. And that could help you make something happen. So you can communicate effectively, and you could buy and sell and promote right now. So I'd get the word out if I were you, Aquarius, because I think there are some people that are looking at you very favorably right now. And I hope you follow up on that. All right, what does it mean to a Pisces? Well, Pisces, this is simply a time with no planets in water signs when the focus may not be on you. But remember I said that because there are no planets in water signs, that we can all be rather sure of our feelings. We don't need to be wondering how we feel about people, and we don't have to wonder how they feel about us. And so I think that people are a little bit emotionally exhausted right now from the uncertainty and the fluctuations in our economy and in our politics. And Pisces, since your sign rules synthesis, you can certainly take a look at the big picture, which you're very good at, and you can overlook a few of the small details that are really getting some other people down. So you could actually be an inspiration to others right now, Pisces, and I hope you are thinking about that. Because this is simply a time in your own quiet way when you can support people who may have their doubts or who can be a little bit afraid to try something new. But believe me, Pisces, if you're the backup for other people, they will treat you as if you are an angel. And that is a role that you fulfill really well. So I'm glad to say that maybe some of your best efforts won't show outwardly, but they certainly will be felt by the people who need your sympathetic understanding. And also, since Pisces is the sign of forgiveness, that is one essential ingredient of being a good partner, sort of forgetting and forgetting. And I think that you are a person that can teach other people how to do that, which is really great, Pisces. I think that we're coming to the end of our show right now, and so I want to wish you all well as you make something happen, because I think this is the week you can do it. Thank you, and I'll see you next Thursday right here at 7 p.m. for Starborn.